Once upon a time, there were three little pigs, and they decided to build themselves a house each. The first little pig built himself a neat little house of straw. The second little pig built his house of sticks, but the third little pig built his house of bricks. By and by, along came Mr. Wolf to the first little pig's house.
Little pig, little pig, let me in.
But the little pig knew the bad wolf's voice, and he called out,
No, no, by the hair of my chinny chin chin, I will not let you in.
Then I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in.
So he huffed, and he puffed, till he blew the house in. But the first little pig just had time, while the wolf was getting his breath back, to rush as hard as he could to the second pig's little house, made of sticks.
Oh, I just got here. Close the door, quick!
And they lived happily together for a while. But by and by, Mr. Wolf passed the house made of sticks, and he thought to himself,
I smell pig. Little pig, little pig, let me in.
But the second little pig peeped through a crack in the door, and he called,
No, no, by the hair of my chinny chin chin, I will not let you in.
Then I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in.
So the wolf huffed, and he puffed, and huffed, until he blew the house of sticks right in. But the two little pigs didn't wait till the wolf got his breath back. They ran, and they ran, until they reached the third little pig's house made of brick.
We just made it. Close the door, quick!
Of course, it had taken a lot longer to build, but it was stronger, and the three little pigs felt safe and happy. But pretty soon, Mr. Wolf came sniffing around, and he crept up to the door and smelt the little pigs inside.
Little pig! Little pig, let me in!
No, no, by the hair of my chinny chin chin, I will not let you in.
Then I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in.
And he huffed, and he puffed, and he puffed, and he huffed. But he couldn't blow that house in. Then the wolf sat down to think. And he knocked at the house again.
Little pig, I can tell you where there are some nice turnips.
Where are the turnips?
In the field at the top of the lane. I'll meet you at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning, and we'll go there together.
Yes, I'll be ready.
But the third little pig got up at 5 o'clock and ran down the lane and was safely home with the turnips when the wolf knocked at 6 o'clock.
Little pig, are you ready?
Ready? I've been and come back with the turnips.
The wolf was very cross, but said,
Little pig, I know a tree where there are some beautiful apples.
Oh, where are those apples?
On a tree in a field in the next lane. Be sure you are ready at 5 o'clock.
But next morning, the little pig got up at 4 o'clock, climbed the tree, and picked the apples. But Mr. Wolf had got up early too, and there he was standing under the tree, waiting.
Why didn't you wait for me, little pig? Are they nice apples?
Very nice. Let me throw you one.
But he threw the apple as far as he could, and while the wolf ran to get it, the little pig jumped down and ran as fast as he could to his little house and slammed the door just in time. Next day, Mr. Wolf knocked and called out,
Little pig! Little pig, there is a fair in the village today. Will you come to it with me? Be ready at 3 o'clock.
Oh, yes, I'll be ready.
But the little pig went very early to the fair, bought a wooden barrel for a butter churn, and when he was nearly home, he saw the wolf. Oh, he was very frightened and jumped inside the butter churn. It tipped on its side and went rolling down the hill. This frightened Mr. Wolf, and he ran into the woods. But next day he was back at the little brick house.
Little pig! Little pig, let me in!
Oh, no, 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 by the hair of my chinny chin chin!
Then I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in!
Then the wolf began quietly to climb up onto the roof. Very quietly, the three little pigs built up the fire, and soon a big pot of hot water was really boiling. They heard the wolf coming down the chimney after them.
Come on, wolf! Come on! Come on!
And the wolf got so cross and so excited that he came down far too quickly and fell plop into the pan of boiling water. And that was the end of the wicked wolf. And the three little pigs stayed together safely and happily in their dear little brick house.